Hello everybody, welcome to Luxury Benefits channel, and in this video we will talk about bad vision habits, correct posture for eyesight, and relaxation exercises for your vision. First of all, you need to understand the essence of how your vision improves and what makes your vision worsening. And it is usually because of the bad habits of looking incorrectly, rarely blinking, staring at objects, looking very narrow. It is also about that myopia is translated as squinting, narrowing of the optic gap to look closely. All of this causes provokes a large muscle spasm. And muscle spasm is kind of form of poor vision, because some muscle is overstrained, while the tension doesn't relieve and at the same time changes the shape of the eyes. Also, a long narrow look, for example, at the monitor, it tires the retina of the eye. Harmfulness lies in the fact that a person doesn't actively perceive the environment, and his vision is narrowed and limited and fixed, and the function of accommodation of vision atrophies. And there is an exercise that relieves this stress, which we will talk about. Preparation for the relaxation exercise will be a correct posture. If you put an ordinary stick to the spine, you must certainly feel the line of the stick with the back of your head and tailbone at the same time. Then the body is stretched along the line of the stick, keeping the back arch and chin down naturally. The ideal position for the body and eyes is when you sit, shifting your weight, your body, on your hips and buttocks. For this, the lower torso slightly moves back. The body itself is slightly forward and between the back of the head. The neck and upper back are in a straight line, when the tailbone and sacrum are completely unloaded, and the body itself becomes relaxed. Try to swing your body back and forth in this position, or right and left. Make smooth movement. The head at the same time moves with the body. The chin doesn't stretch forward, but continues look down. If you sit down correctly and your body relaxes, it is easy for you and you will succeed. To make it with a straight or with a bent back, impossible. Make sure that the top of your head is always stretched up. The shoulders are pulled as far as possible out from the ears, and the shoulder blades are slightly flattened to each other. It will be difficult to control the position of the body at first, but then in the wrong position you will feel uncomfortable. Unfortunately, the habit of sitting with raised shoulders, tilted in one side head and resting on the tailbone is so common among people that most do not ever notice how tense it at the same time as their body. And a person gets tired most often not from work and all kind of deeds, but from improper tense position of the body. From unwillingness to follow your posture and control your posture while awake. By the way, research shown that the office workers all day straining their eyes by the evening get tired much more than construction builder who are laying bricks. Low movement state, constant eye strain under artificial lighting and conditioned air have a much more detrimental impact on health and vision than a hard physical work. Now that we have mastered the correct posture, we can talk about the most important reception of stress relief according to Bates, which is called moving wiggles and turns. Move, wiggle and turn for stress relief exercise bear wiggle, called in China swaying an elephant. Taoist Qigong teachers practice and taught for centuries. Dr. Bates mastered this technique in the beginning of the 20th century. I discovered that, if done correctly, long swaying, as they also called vision, is restored much faster than doing any other methods, it taught his student. Simple wiggles. So you need to get up and depict how the bear behaves in a cage. That's right, feet, shoulders, width apart, body slightly tilted forward, arms hang freely along the body. In this state, smoothly transfer body weight from one leg to another. Head and body monotonously swing from right to left. After a while, you will enter a certain state of prostration, relaxation, and detachment. If, of course, the exercise is done correctly. By the way, why do bears behave like that in a cage? And not only them. Many people have observed at the zoo as with endless monotony rush to and from predators, especially from the family felines, as elephants shake their trunk and head evenly, as monkeys swing on branches and spine in a squirrel wheel. Animals in the way, I think, protect themselves from the stress, which is, for any living being, lack of freedom, limited space and lack of the movement. Unconsciously creating the illusion of movement, animals both calm down and fight hypodynamia. It is surprising that the children and orphanages also often sway to the left or to the left or back and forth when they sit or stand. A way to calm and rock yourself. Even nursing babies chat head back and forth, subconsciously confronting that successful situation in which they found themselves sense to adults. This deprivation mechanism persists in such children for life, even if it gets into prosperous family. Well-off adults too sometimes start to unconsciously shake head, for example, in a moment of deep emotional experience. Why? Again, apparently there is some conscious defense of the body from excessive experiences. The mechanism of self-regulation and self-balancing are turned on. This happens primarily through the eyes and the brain. The same picture floating before the eyes many times. Send a signal to the brain, you don't need to look at anything, we see the same thing all the time. Excitation of nerve cells is removed through visual analyzers, retinas, and they relax. Through the peripheral nervous system, the relaxation signal is transmitted to the central nervous system, and eventually stress is removed from the eyes, and from the body, and from the psycho-emotional sphere. Thus, hanging the swing cradle from the ceiling, the child was, as we see, a rather with decision. Especially if mother and grandmother sang at the same time some kind of lullaby song. Now parents swing the child in a stroller on their arms, and often many don't even think why the child is better after that falls asleep. Just choose which swaying you like more, standing or sitting, and do them to relieve tensions and spasms. Because during these exercises, thinking and internal dialogue stops, and you relax, forgetting about stresses and concentrating on finding pleasant feeling. Thanks for watching this video to the very end. Subscribe to my channel and hopefully we'll see you again.